You're about to watch the world's first live interactive drama. Probably we had a quick Google and couldn't find anything else, but we'll say we're the first. I'm here to explain to you how that interaction is going to work. So throughout the story, there are 3 points when you get to choose what happens. For the first two, it's a case of who you're going to investigate, who you're going to question. For the third, it's the accusation scene, the big one. Will you get it right or will you get it wrong? It should all be relatively self-explanatory, especially if you've watched something like Bandersnatch. Except things like Bandersnatch typically have a freeze frame where you get to make your decision. We're live? We can't do that. So instead, we're going for a series of polls on our Facebook page. That's facebook.com/YorkStudentTelevision. Now, I recommend using a second screen, something like a laptop or a tablet or a phone, just to make sure you're there ready for when it's time to vote. And when it is time to vote, you'll see a little graphic on the screen. As soon as you see that, head on over. The quicker you vote, the easier it is for us in the gallery to relay your decisions to the floor, making sure it's you that shapes the story. So again, our Facebook page is facebook.com/YorkStudentTelevision. That's facebook.com/YorkStudentTelevision. Again, I'm giving you a little bit of time to open up that tab, open the app, get ready, get loaded. Well, now it's time to actually go, I guess. Good luck. Happy sleuthing. Because I hear there's been a murder.
Obviously, IPA comes from India, which gives it that hoppiness you just don't get with German beers.
No way.
Now, the best way to drink IPA is from a bottle, but since we're at a party, I've gone for this red plastic cup, as that seems to be the done thing here. Now, tell me, Charlie, was it? What constitutes your ideal ale?
I couldn't possibly say.
Oh, you!
Oh my god, it's burning my throat. I mean, it's fine, it's quite good. You should try it.
Bad.
Whatever. These are quite good too. Yeah.
Has anyone seen a packet anywhere? It's because I can't have gluten and sometimes the flavourings have gluten.
Yes! Rocking that gluten-free lifestyle. Love it.
I wonder what you exactly call being celiac a lifestyle, but...
Good gravy. Are you okay? I mean, wasn't that bad. Not even that strong, I mean... I'm another heavyweight myself, but I mean, more water? I mean, surely don't need that much water. That's a lot of water. Oh, hello there.
Bless her. Well, I'm sure she'll be back through in a minute. Does anyone know who she is?
Can't say I do. So, no change there then. Say, Violet, how are we doing via the avoidance of Peter's untimely death at the hands of a dubiously spiced potato-based snack?
Nathan.
It's Nigel?
Nope, I'm pretty sure it was Nathan. Anyways, I wasn't trying to find your packet. I was trying to find a speaker. We need some tunes.
Yeah, but, well, I mean, if no one's really sure about the gluten in the crisps, I'll just go upstairs to the loo.
Gross. TMI. Violet, isn't that a speaker over there? Oh my goodness, you're such a darling.
Thanks, hon.
Don't mention it.
And that is why I tune into the shipping forecast every morning. It truly is the BBC's most fantastic programming. And that's including the televisual content. Sherlock makes Doctor Who look like a pile of wank.
Your words are boring, but it's okay because I have music.
Right, I'm going to the toilet.
And then you get this here bed and you use it as a palate cleanser for the next thing. It's like what my old man used to say. Therese, use your loaf.
I'm not quite sure that's what he meant.
Of course he did. Anyway, Mr. Nigel, sir, don't you have any of those kind of sayings in your family?
Well, free will is an illusion bestowed upon us by the cruel tricksters we call gods. We're nothing but dolls, puppets, only elevated by the belief that we are greater.
A more meant about food?
Oh, no.
Right.
Yeah, getting rather tired. I just, you know.
I'm gonna go check on that girl.
Yeah, good idea. I'll just got the snacks. Well, nice one, Nigel.
Do you know if she's in there?
I don't know. I've just come down to wait for the toilets.
Right. I mean, I hope you're not too desperate.
I'll be all right, don't worry.
Hey, are you in there? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to spook you with the water and that. It's just... Please, sir! There's been a murder!
Therese? What?
Violet? Violet? You know, this reminds me of the time where I lost my hair. I was out hunting. My best friend Sebastian, the moors of Shropshire. Like the young fool I was, I forgot to wear ear protection. So when I first fired the shotgun, I was disorientated as the devil. Ah, I was so disorientated, in fact, that I did realize that the second shot I took actually hit Sebastian. Oh, I was very rich, so, you know, costs weren't involved. Oh, yes, nice. I'm sure there hasn't been a catastrophe, but I better go pop out anyway. Violet?
Are you okay?
Nigel, it's awful!
Did someone say there'd been a murder?
In here?
Yes, Charlie's gone in ahead.
God.
There's no sign of any cuts or bruises.
What are you?
Oh, I'm conducting a secondary survey. I'm first aid trained, so
with
I thought.
With all due respect, Charlie, ain't no much bloody point in that now, is there?
He has got a point. The time for first aid has been and gone. Chief Hovis. Brown bread?
She's dead.
It is useful information, though. Thank you. That being said, you have tampered with a crime scene.
A crime scene?
Well, yes, a crime scene. People don't tend to just asphyxiate themselves and... God, I mean, finding the strength to finish oneself off when you're oxygen deprived becomes rather difficult.
So you're telling me that someone came into this house without any of us knowing, somehow managed to sneak up on this young woman in this very small room and kill her at close quarters with no signs of a struggle. Well, that's poppycock.
Not quite. I don't think much anyone else entered the house. Therefore, to put it simply, one of you killed her.
One of who killed her?
Us?
Unless you haven't noticed, Mr. Detective, we have all been partying. So why is it that you make all the rules? How do we know that you aren't the murderer?
Violet, I've been in the living room since I've arrived, and I think I remember killing someone. Since I don't, I know it wasn't me. And Theresa was with me the whole time until she left to find our guest. And by my reckoning, it'll be borderline imbecilic to alert the whole house to a murder you've just committed. Hence, we are each other's alibis. And as for the four of you, I don't have comprehensive knowledge of your actions. Ergo, you are all suspects.
Well, this is preposterous.
Oh, is it, Castor? Because I actually think it's rather serious. Now, Therese, would you do me a favor and ask next door for help?
I'll get right on it.
Okay, meanwhile, we best start on the body. Does anyone perchance have a pair of gloves I could use?
Yeah, sure.
And why exactly do you have a pair of gloves?
I'm a biologist. Never know when you're gonna need them.
Just one moment. There we are. Hello, baby.
So you have a pair of gloves and you have a magnifying glass.
You don't carry around a magnifying glass with you? Yeah, and I'm the weird one.
Nigel, I tried unlocking the door, but it was locked shut, and I tried turning the little mechanism thing, but it physically wouldn't turn.
And that was me trying the police. Nothing, nada, didn't even connect.
This is all so weird. Phone's not working. Oh, and all the creaking floorboards in this house. It's like one of those Halloween films.
Is it?
Oh, yeah, I've not seen. It's like Friday the 13th or Funny Games or The Thing.
Well, I've not seen any of them, so can we
please... You've not seen those either? What have you seen?
Well, I don't know. Nanny McPhee and the Big Bang.
You've not seen The Thing, but you've seen Nanny McPhee too.
Wait, there's another Nanny McPhee film?
Sorry, but she's dead. I mean, isn't that a little bit more important than who's seen Nanny McPhee too? I mean, if the murderer is still out there, then... Oh, I think I need to lie down.
I'll go make sure he's okay.
Right. Anyway... Best be on with this mystery. What do you think happened here, Charlie?
She's dead, Nigel.
Yes.
She probably strangled by that violin string, I'd imagine.
Too right. But something about this just doesn't add up.
There was another thing. While I was conducting my survey, I found her wallet. She's called Nina. That's her name.
Nina, eh? Well, we're going to get to the bottom of this. For you.